anyway.
I'll leave that for now.
Okay.
Let's talk a little bit about the budget, because I know that's been top of mind for you.
It's
really a tough situation for everybody, and right. I guess that the topper for you was, correct me if I'm stating this wrong, but it sounds like you knew $22 million in cuts were coming.
Mm-hmm.
That was expected.
Cuts and savings, yeah.
Right. You had already counted on how you were going to frame the department given those cuts.
Right.
And then sort of, I guess the word is blindsided. You were with $6 million in additional.
$6 million surprise. Yes. Let me take those two pieces separately, because I want to make this very clear. These cuts are not my cuts. These cuts in services are going to belong to the mayor's office or the city council if they pass this budget the way it's written. Because they came over and I said, look, I will tell you where I will make the cuts in services corresponding with the cuts in revenue that you are taking out of my budget. But know this, that is not how I would handle this. What I would do is I would ask people to pay what they paid last year in property taxes so I can give them the same service that I gave them last year. If they don't pay the same this year that they paid last year, I cannot give them the same service this year that I gave them last year. So that's the first piece of it. Then the $6 million piece of it, I've gone back and identified in this budget about $8.8 million in savings. A lot of it's in vacancies that we carried and cuts, and then the officers took a 3% cut in salary. There's about $8.8 million that we've been able to save this year, because when the officers took that cut back first quarter of the year, I didn't go out and hire those other officers back that we laid off last year, those 74 or 48 police officers, because I knew that this day was coming.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't want to hire them in, you know, March or April and then lay them off in October.
Right.
So we carried that, saved that $8.8 million. So I'm introducing through the council president, asking him to introduce an ordinance that will allow me to take $6.1 million of my $8.8 million savings,
right,
and use that to make up the $6.1 million that they just indiscriminately cut out of my budget. Give that back. That way I don't have to cut 114 police positions. Everybody talks about 95.
Mm-hmm.
No, it's not 95, it's 114. There are 95 police officers that would get laid off.
Okay.
But it would be 114 positions because I would have to cut some vacancies that we have right now. So that would take care of the police officers if they will simply let me have my savings, and not even all of it. I'm just asking for the 6.1 of that $8.8 million.
All right, let's take a break just for a second.
On the other side, let me make sure everybody understands this too, Donna. The main cuts in that first $22 million in cuts and savings that we talked about was closing our third jail, where an incredible drug treatment program is located, laying off all of our CSOs who work traffic crashes out there.
Right.
That's the biggest portion of this.
Right.
Now, in that $10 million, those two things, all I'm asking for out of that, if people pay this year what they paid last year, the city would have an additional $22 to $24 million. Our revenue is going down by $22 to $24 million. If people pay the same, the city would have that revenue. I'm only asking for $10 million of it to allow me to keep this drug treatment program in this third jail running and keep our community service officers out there. The other millions of dollars that we cut, we're not asking for that back.
Okay. Let me just take a quick break, Sheriff. We're going to talk to you for another segment here.
Okay.
We'll talk more about the possibility in terms of